In this video, you will learn about how to use Hall effect sensors to make thumbstick and triggers similar to what might be found in gaming controllers and virtual reality controllers. Triggers, a kinesthetic control feature common to most, if not all, gaming controllers, allow gamers to hit the gas in racing games, fire weapons or raise shields for their avatars, or zoom in on areas in their avatar's field of view. As gaming controllers and their respective controls are modular devices intended for servicing all games, the sensors they are composed of need to provide accurate analog measurements such that the software developer has the flexibility to specify analog or binary states in accord with what is most suitable for their game. Aside from fulfilling the primary purpose of accurate position measurement, triggers need to be efficient. As controllers are battery powered, there is always the challenge of reducing power consumption and making the controller as efficient as possible, so gamers can have the longest bout of uninterrupted gameplay possible. One method that circuit designers have leveraged in the elusive quest for minimal power loss is duty cycling the supply to the sensor. The idea is that the sensor does not always need to be on for the gamer to have an optimal gaming experience. During the cycled off times, only parasitic leakage losses will occur through the sensor, which will be much smaller than the losses during normal active operation. In the past, additional components called load switches were used to duty cycle the Hall effect sensors. Fortunately, with modern Hall effect sensors, not only can accurate position be determined, but improved architectures are driving down active current consumption and integrating features like enable pins to free up board space and further improve system efficiency. Thumbsticks, yet another important control common to gaming controllers, allow users to control their avatar's traveling direction, adjust the direction of the field of view, aim weapons, and scroll through menus. Aside from having many of the same concerns as triggers with accuracy and power, drift in particular is of great concern for thumbsticks. Historically, potentiometers were used for translating position. As the average thumbstick is subjected to hundreds of hours of intense gameplay, the potentiometer wipers often degrade, leading to a noticeable drift issue that causes unintentional movement. Thumbsticks exhibiting drift will lead to avatars moving when they should not, struggling to aim, or struggling to make precise movements. As Hall effect sensors do not need to maintain continuity through abrasive contacts for discerning movement and position, they are not expected to suffer from the drift issue and therefore are a robust alternative for transducing user position input with the thumbstick. Texas Instruments' magnetic sensing portfolio provides excellent options when designing for a gaming controller, trigger, or thumbstick. T-Mag 5253, available in a small X2SON package, is equipped with an enable pin so that it can be duty cycled on and off to save power. The T-Mag 5273 is a system on chip which is capable of measuring all three magnetic field vector components, allowing flexibility in hardware design. Outfitted with multiple operating modes for reducing power consumption, including self-duty cycling, conversion on demand, and wake on magnetic threshold detection. Triggers are ergonomically designed for simple tactile feedback and control with the trigger fingers. Typically, designs operate as a hinge. When a magnet is appropriately placed in such a hinge, a Hall effect sensor like the T-Mag 5253 can be used to translate the angle of the hinge into some analog output that some microcontroller can process. Thumbsticks have 2 degrees of freedom, allowing roll and pitch, which cumulatively give the perception of rotation suitable for controlling any operations related to direction. In this thumbstick, 2 Hall effect sensors and 2 magnets are used to capture the roll and pitch to calculate the thumbstick rotation. For the thumbstick, the goal is to map the pitch in the X-axis and Y-axis into some rotation and pitch angle that is the hypotenuse of both x and y pitch angles. The rotation values can then be grouped into some discrete direction software command, while the pitch might translate into speed or magnitude of the direction command. For a given magnet sensor pairing, the pitch of the thumbstick along its axis can be determined by a rotating magnet. In this case, the thumbstick x-axis position is captured through measuring the B field of a magnet rotating in an XZ plane. This sensor, designated for the thumbstick's x-axis, measures the field it sees along the z-axis, which is relatively linear. This principle is then also applied to the thumbstick's y-axis. For quickly putting together a design, you can use TI's Magnetic Sense Simulator, or TIMS. The form factor of your thumbstick and the enclosure it is contained in will set the upper bound of the magnet size, magnet movement path, and sensor magnet offsets. Manufacturing tolerance and cost will likely set the lower bound. Typical thumbsticks are small, and diametric magnets often are more expensive. Consequently, a neodymium bar magnet is considered. This magnet is 2.46 millimeters by 0.95 millimeters by 3.45 millimeters. The tool works in rectangular coordinates, requiring X, Y, and Z position information with respect to the fulcrum point. Once those values are entered, a device along with its operating voltage can be defined. In this case, we chose the TMAG5273. Based on the entries provided, the tool generates the following outputs. For a sanity check, the tool generates a model of the sensor location and the magnet with its trajectory of movement as shown on the left. Along with the model, the expected B fields are plotted. In this case, we see the B field along the sensor Z axis is relatively linear. The position at 30 degrees corresponds to the default idle position. For the trigger, a single magnet swinging toward a sensor on a hinge can be used. In this case, a simple Z axis sensing device, the TMAG5253, is used. For this design, the goal is to have a unique voltage for each angle and, if possible, try to tailor the magnet orientation such that it is relatively linear. Yet again, the TIMS TI Magnetic Sense Simulator can be used for iterating through various design parameters and finding the optimal magnet and sensor pairing for this application. In this case, a cylindrical, axially magnetized ferrite magnet is evaluated. This was selected because it is a cheap, readily available magnet. As before, we get B field value calculations per the conditions we set in the entry form. Only the Z axis is relevant, and we see that it satisfies the criteria of not suffering aliasing and having relatively linear response. After designing the thumbstick and triggers, some bench testing should be carried out to validate the thumbstick and trigger performance. Properly set up bench tests can help reveal how manufacturing tolerances might affect design and may alert the designer to issues previously unaccounted for in the preliminary design. For the trigger, sensor output with respect to movement was compared against a protractor in a recorded video. As for the thumbstick, we used a 3D printer outfitted with a custom attachment and controlled by G-code, tailored for moving the thumbstick precisely to locations of interest. After the isolated trigger and thumbstick blocks were tested, we integrated them into our generic rendition of the gaming controller and output the sensed measurements in PuTTY. This concludes our demonstration. To learn more about how to use Hall effect sensors for your design, we recommend reading the trigger design application note and lever and joystick design application notes. For these and other useful articles and tools, please visit ti.com/halleffect.